Hello and welcome back to Hearthstone, the League of Explorers. Now, what's got me all excited is I checked out that last video, and I actually think I was a little bit too loud! So I've turned my mic down a little bit, which should, in fact, you know, make the sound clarity even better. Because even though this beautiful, beautiful mic, as far as I can tell, didn't even pick up any background noise at all, if I turn down the boosting, that'll make things clearer, and if I can afford to do that, oh, that's so good. I cannot believe I was too loud. I mean, obviously, being too loud is fine, because you can just turn your video down, and that's exactly what I said I wanted to do. But if I can just find an even better balance, that is awesome. I can't believe, after years and years of making videos that are just uncomfortably quiet compared to every other video on YouTube, I'm finally there. I have made it to the ranks of an equitable volume. So, we're going to fight Captain Skarvash for the third time. I haven't made a new deck for it because I already have a handlock called the Hand of Gul'dan. We're just going to see if that works. If it doesn't work, then I'm thinking of some kind of paladin. Sorry. Too excited, you see. Too excited. I'm thinking of, yeah, a paladin.
Gul'dan versus Skarvash.
Something with a lot of weapons. Something annoying.
Uldaman for frogs only. Your soul shall be mine.
Of course, Voidwalker. A beautiful turn one minion that I will not be able to use on turn one. But this Neruvian Egg, I can use that on turn two, and that's always a good thing to have on turn two. Or I could use two Voidwalker minions. Really, the world is my oyster. Though I think what I'm going to do is Egg on two, minion on three. So, unless I get a spell that costs three and I really want to use instead, but I didn't, so it's egg time. Now for those who don't know what an Arubian egg does, basically it's a 0-2, but when it dies, summons a rather beefy 4-4, so my hope is that I can get the beef, and get the beef on the board. And I'm going to put him down.
Why do you call?
He's going to solve every problem for me. Alright, and now, okay. So I can't use Implosion next turn, but I can put down a rather juicy Void Caller. See, things are already looking better for me. I'm getting fewer turns where I can't do anything. Now, he would be just a perfect target for a good Implosion. The problem with Implosion is it deals between 2 to 4 damage. I want it to deal 4 damage or it's no good. But I probably won't get that lucky, so... Now that is tempting because then he's forced to activate my egg. So actually, that's how I'm going to play this. I'm going to play this.
My shield for Argon.
As you command.
I'm thinking hard about this because if I kill the Trog, then that's good, but then I have to hit three with Implosion in order to kill. If I kill him, then maybe things will go worse for me, but he's a definite Implosion kill. So actually, I'll take the risk. Now, the bad thing to do would be if he hits the egg, which leaves the Trog alive.
Ancient curse.
Alright, he's got two curses in his deck. That could go well. Okay, so yeah. The Trog is left alive. I suppose I can at least get rid of it with the thing. Now... Okay, I think what I need to do,
into the breach.
The most risk-free way to do this, is to do this, this, and this. If it hits for four, then it hits for four. I could have, you know, I could have killed the other one with that implosion, but it wasn't guaranteed. So this was how it had to be. So that Earthen Pursuer, I could kill him, but it would clear my entire board. However, this looks better for me. So if I get in there and fight Magot, then I still have a decent board. There you go, now who's taking control? Looks like we can actually get this done. So what's he going to play? Oh, Starfire. Who's that going to get? He called my bluff. I have no demons in my hand. So, Never mind. An Imp Gang boss, though. I can do that. Let's get the other card first, though. See what it is. Imp Gang boss is the clear winner. Let's start chipping away. There we go. It looks like the Hand of Gul'dan is in fact what we needed to get this done. Not that I should speak so quickly, of course. It still has 23 health. And that rumbling element... Oh, a rumbly in the jungle. Oh! Your secret is now mine. Kazan Mystic. This is the only deck I've ever played that runs a Kazan Mystic, but now I am so glad for that fact.
The light does not discriminate.
Alright. Now, it's when using a hero power. Does he even use his hero power? Am I ever going to be able to use this? If not, then at least, you know, it still can't be used against me. So, let's light up. You know what? This isn't a handlock. This is a Zoolock. I used to have a handlock called the Hand of Gul'dan, but then I turned it to a Zoolock and didn't change its name. So... Alright, now the question is, do I go for control? I think going for control is the best idea, so... I could deal all this damage to the face, but I want him to have nothing on the board. You know, I want to give him as few chances to overwhelm me as is possible. Let's stick a spider on there. For those who don't know what this does, it summons 2/1/1 spiders when it dies, so it's a nice sticky minion. Alright, whenever you overload... That actually feels like... That feels better for me. I'm happy with this turn of events. Yeah, this is fine. This is fine. How do I want to do this? If I could... Yeah, I will... Imp Gang to get another imp. And spiders to get some spiders. Nerubian Egg. Hurt myself a little bit. And... So there you go, my board is full. I feel like I've confidently won this one now.
The Fire Lord.
None may steal our secrets.
I don't feel too threatened by that. That's actually crap. Keeper of Uldaman. I mean, okay, it's good for getting rid of high health minions, I suppose, but I don't know. I'm not sure how I feel about that. Let me do some maths here. Alright, 1, 2, 3, 6, 9, 12.
Who dares summon me?
Alright, Mal'Ganis, you are beautiful, but we will not see you this day. I think I've won. I got sloppy with the mask at the end because I got overexcited, but I think this is it. I think we're done. So what cards do we get?
This way, hero. Hop in the minecart.
I shall do so. All right, Tunnel Trog looks cool. Ethereal. Ooh, Battlecry. Discover a spell. Not sure how I feel about that 3 health though. Minions with high attack and 3 health are never as good as they might look. The high attack, it looks fancy, but they just get killed too quickly. There are too many ways to kill minions in this game. Never worth it. So what do we got now?
This mine shaft leads straight to the center of Uldaman.
Alright, so they've definitely changed what Uldaman's all about, because obviously this... There was never a minecart rush in Uldaman. Escape the Trogs. It's another temple run thing. Alright, well, as I don't know what I'm doing, then I'm just going to go for the Shama Banana. If I'm allowed. No! Alright.
Watch out! We're being chased!
Alright, we are being chased, and I have an entirely new deck. So I don't know how it works, so let's have a look. We've got Taunt and can't attack. Alright, that's pretty good. Mechanical Parrot. Ooh, these are very powerful cards. Okay. Repairs, barrel forward. And the hero power is deal 3 down to a random enemy minion. Okay. I'm fine with this.
Fly, Ginny!
Who's Ginny? Who's Ginny? I have never in World of Warcraft heard Bran Bronzebeard refer to anyone as Ginny. Alright. Alright, so... I feel like we should barrel forward. Let's consult Bran first. Alright, looks like everything I can do is, one cost, which sounds good to me. Let's get Spike's decoy up. They just feel like they'll keep me safe. In fact, the safest thing, probably, is to save this barrel forward until it will win the game for me. Because otherwise, I'll come up with challenges just too much for me. At least that's how I feel that this game's going to go anyway. Let's get the parrots out there. We have repairs available, so we don't need to worry about that. We definitely need those repairs now. Quite badly. In fact, I want another repair, let's be honest. Alright. I feel like I have to sacrifice this bird. I need to heal myself. And I should probably dynamite one of these guys.
Be careful with that stuff! You took out a chunk of the track!
Sorry. But yeah, I feel like the hero power, I shouldn't really be using that. Unless I'm pretty sure I can kill something with it. And now I'm not at all sure I can kill something with it. Alright. Okay, this is not going to help me at all. So, let's throw rocks, and if it doesn't kill this, then I'll kill this. But I still lose.
Full speed ahead!
Well done.
So let's try that again. Obviously, no need for deck revisions, because it's set deck. I just need to really learn how to do this. Learn what the best way is to get out of this mine. So yeah, I'm liking these more fun, sort of gimmicky levels. It's a cool step forward for Adventure Mode. Because the thing is, what I've been thinking about in terms of like Hearthstone going forward, a bit of a worry for me, for moi, is that the more Hearthstone goes on, the more cards get added, which means the more difficult it is to get into it, because you know, when I first started Hearthstone, which is when the game first came out, it wasn't too hard for me to catch up. But now, if I was starting and not intending to spend loads of money, it would be really difficult for me to catch up. So you know, the more these adventure modes, which are a little bit more affordable than buying loads of packs, and they give you really decent cards just for beating them, the more these have bosses that aren't reliant on you having good decks already, just the better a chance a newcomer has, I feel like. Because, you know, that's a serious concern going forward. I don't know why I'm concerned. I am not this game's designer, but, you know, if I was a game's designer on this, I would think, you know, the longer we go, the more daunting it's going to be for new players. So how do we fix that? That is something I would very much think about. So there you go. You've learned what goes on in my head. Alright, those lumbering golems are making me wish I kept some of my dynamite, but you do what you have to do as you have to do it. So, who are you gonna get? Alright, that's good. I'm pleased. Though I have the sneaking suspicion I'm going to take 12 damage next turn. Here it comes! Oh wait, I only get 2 mana maximum. That's upsetting. Boom!
That'll teach him!
Solved it! There you go.
Ha-ha! Riding carts and throwing bombs! This is a blast!
If you say so, Bran Bronzebeard. Alright, so I can get some repairs up nice and easy. But I think I will. Well, only one of them. Because otherwise there will be wasted potential there. Alright, so when I get to two turns to escape, I'm just going to barrel forward twice, and that should win the game for me, as far as I know. Okay. Alright, Dynamite. So, now... There you go! Good result! And if I understand this correctly, I'm about to win. That is my understanding of the situation. Let's see if it works. Game won! Game absolutely won.
Lost them! The headpiece is in the next room!
Battlecry, discover a beast. 3-3 for 4, I don't know. I just don't know. It all depends on just how good this discover mechanic ends up being. I mean, you see how good I am at building decks. I am not knowledgeable enough of this game to understand and learn things. I cannot look at a new thing and think how good it's going to be. I can only look at what the pros do and then copy them. So what's this? Unearth Raptor. Choose a friendly minion. Gain a copy of its Death Rattle effect. Now that could be very cool, because there are some minions in this game with very powerful Death Rattles. Alright, and what's the fight? Oh, is this Arcadus?
Yeah, the stone giant Arcadus has got the headpiece, but he won't give it up without a fight.
Alright, so Arcadus is indeed a boss in Uldaman. He's the final boss of Uldaman. He is the only character I have seen in World of Warcraft that uses the word ye. When you're fighting him, he says, "Awake, ye servants, defend your master," and summon some ads. No one else in WoW speaks in that cringy ye olde Englishy except this guy. So what's his hero power? Summon an 0-2 statue for both players. So basically, summon a totem. A taunt totem. Speaking of taunt totems, it's time for Shama Banana to take the stage again. Especially if he's going to summon 0-2 to me and I get some bananas going. Could go well.
Arcadus!
The wrath of the makers.
Alright, good opening hand. Good opening hand, we're gonna keep it. That is zombie, totem, totemic, thingy doodle.
A servant of the ancient titans. Oh, the stories he could tell us.
If he weren't too busy burying you in stone.
Oh, Elsie. What are you even doing in the Explorers League if you don't have a ridiculous, self-defeating love for exploration? Oh, I assume this had taunt, but it doesn't have taunt. But even so, it's going to be better for me than it is for him. So I guess the worry is that he could flood my board with, you know, 0-2s and I couldn't do anything. So a deck that's going to beat this guy is a deck... is a deck that has minion buffing capacities.
Did you bring some fish?
I know some words, maybe. Luckily, Shama Banana does have minion buffing capacities, so... I'm quite pleased. Though I'm about to run out of space. There you go, space run out of. Alright, kill something, that suits me just fine. Yes! Alright, you've killed him, but that just means that I can get some tasty 1-3s on the board.
My shield for
Alright, I feel very much in control right now. Definitely, definitely in control. So, how are you gonna win, Bubbaloo? Bubba Hubba? Alright, a paladin secret. That could be one of a billion different things. Give it the minion 1-1 and taunt. A clever plan. If not for this. Alright, so it's not a fallen defender. It's not a redemption. It's nothing. Well, it's something. But I don't know what it is. So let's just keep hitting him in the face. Suits me. It's not eye for an eye. There we go, we're narrowing it down. Could it be vengeance or revenge or whatever it's called? Avenge. There you go.
I will bury you.
Who are you dealing damage to? Said for everything done, deal one damage. Deal one damage to whom? Who took that damage? Whom took that damage? Twas not I. Alright, well. Ew, a sacred trial. That's a new secret, one I haven't seen before. Okay, okay.
Into the breach.
Let's get this Naboobian on the go. Let's hit you in the face. Heal him, suits me just fine. Itchy, itchy, face, face. Ew, okay. Yorkie. You have not stymied me yet.
Tusk.
Sorted it. Absolutely smashed it. Thank you very much, Flame Tongue Totem, for doing the hard thinking when I couldn't. There you go, we've just played Doctor Overpowered, and this game is as good as ours. Speaking of, that death rattle, deal 1-4 damage to a random enemy, could go very nicely with the raptor. Oh, so he dealt damage to a minion of his choice, okay. Have I still won, though? How anticlimactic. I just did it. I just won the game.
Piece to go.
3-4 with taunt. That's pretty good. If you have 6 other minions, gain 4-4. Okay, so you fit nicely in a Zoolock deck. I like it. Alright, well, that was Uldaman done. Certainly different to the Wild Uldaman. Your battle cries trigger twice. Okay. Alright, you're going in my Shaman deck. You're going in my Shaman deck so very much. Deal 3 damage to all minions. Shuffle this card into your opponent's deck. Cool. Alright, class challenges.
They've found the second piece. My plan is nearly complete.
Ooh, what secret and overcomplicated plan do you have to rule the world? We'll find out next week in the Ruined City. This is the end of this video. I will, of course, do the class challenges and most probably the heroics, since I set the precedent of doing the heroics last week. But for now, I'm gonna check to see if I now haven't accidentally made my voice too quiet, because that will, you know, that's typical. That's a typical Huffbuh move. But hopefully that has not come to pass. I hope you're enjoying these videos. I certainly am. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you later!